Hello, fellow Warcraft fans. This is Soul with your guide to week 11 of Shadowlands. If you're new around here, be sure to subscribe for more videos like this and all things Warcraft. First off, let's go over some important hotfixes that are going live this week, or you might have missed. Many specs are going to receive a flat damage buff to all of their abilities. Havoc Demon Hunters, Frost Mages, Enhanced Shaman, as well as Arms and Fury Warriors are getting a 3% damage buff across the board. Frost Death Knights, Beast Mastery and Survival Hunters, Assassination Rogues, and Destro Warlocks are getting a 5% damage buff to all their abilities. Now, will this be enough? I've already got the answer for you, it's never enough. Kyrian and Venthyr players might enjoy this one. Followers from the mission table received significant buffs that I'll just throw up on screen here. Substantial increases to health and throughput values should put these two covenants in line with others in terms of running missions of equivalent level. Nightfae will hate this one though. The disposable trapper troops had their ability nerfed, which all but kills the trapper cheese tactic. So you might be up a creek if you have a lot of followers that are still at a low level because you never needed to use them. As a suggestion for everybody, not just Nightfae players, here are two add-ons I recently featured that really help with making running missions easier. Venture Plan displays reward values of missions run with a snazzy UI, making running missions for experience a snap, and can predict whether a team can succeed on a mission with pretty good accuracy. But also consider installing Covenant Mission Helper. This also predicts mission success, giving you two opinions to rely on, and it has an optimize button to shuffle your current team around in a way to increase your success chance. Finally, Blizzard relaxed restrictions on running the cell blocks of Torghast, and now your alts can enter the highest layer that you've ever completed. Yes! The era of buying and selling Torghast runs is now in full swing, and of course, Shadowlands scored a few points for alt friendliness. Way to go! The world boss this week is Mortanis, now that we've gone through another full rotation. Jump in for those item level 200 conduits for your Covenant ability, and for you rogues, warriors, and monks, now is your turn to pick up some hopefully maybe useful legendary recipes. The fourth and final wing of Raidfinder opens up, giving us a crack against Sire Denathrius and his sweet loot table. Just like the Stone Legion, the drops from here have an item level of 194, 7 item level higher than normal bosses. This doesn't include conduits, which are still an item level of 187. With this wing open, this completes full access to PvE content for players of all levels, and now the wait begins to see if there will be any bonus questing content now that everyone is mostly on the same page. For weekly events, we are back to Dungeon Week. Run 4 Mythic Dungeons for a chance at Heroic Raid Gear. Consider completing this for the reward before deciding what to pull from your Great Vault. Who knows, you might get surprised. Brawls are back, and this time it's Warsong Scramble. Grab that flag-carrying set or find a friend that has one and start running. As for me, let's see who can keep up with 17 seconds of horse. And kidney shot. Okay. On to Mythic Plus. So you survived or avoided last week's affixes, or maybe the affixes avoided you. Congratulations. This week we have Fortified, Inspiring, and Storming. Here's a quick reminder on them since these are the newer affixes. Inspiring gives selected mobs an aura that makes enemies around them immune to crowd control. So crowd control the Inspiring mob to separate it from the pack, or kill it dead really quickly to overcome the affix. Storming is a swirly that spawns from enemies. They persist for 10 or so seconds, they move around, and they knock people back, so consider this as a vacation for ranged players and a nightmare for melee and tanks, maybe. Since you're dealing with Fortified and Inspiring, it's going to be up to your team if you want to burst down the Inspiring mob or crowd control it and backpedal when those tornado things appear. I sure hope you don't get Sanguine Depths as your first key, and if you do, feel free to come back here and cuss me out in a comment below. Our last stop today is in Covenant World. The Renown cap has raised another 2 points to 30, and we hit a few new milestones. At Renown 29, we unlock another row for our Soulbinds. Rewards from World Quest will also hit their maximum item level, which is great for more casual-minded players or alts looking for a little extra oomph. At Renown 30, we reach the bottom of our first Soulbinds tree, OMG, which unlocks new perks. Let's take a look at them. Pelagos from the Kyrian learns Let Go of the Past. It's got a bit of a ramp up, but it turns out to be a 3% magic damage reduction. Well, Fathers hide your daughters because Pelagos got magic protection. Woo woo. Moving on, Merilith gives Necrolord players the ultimate form trait, which makes Fleshcraft very powerful, at least in specific situations. With this trait, Fleshcraft makes you immune to crowd control during its channel and for 4 seconds after completing it. This can possibly let you cheese instances where you would otherwise be stunned, or feared, or something else. You're also getting a bit of a heal over time too, which can't hurt. I bet that at least early on you'll be able to fool more than a few players into wasting an interrupt or a stun by casting this in front of their faces. Naya will give Nightfae players a chance to choose between 3 of Naya's tools, which also means choosing a conduit path to go down. Burrs will slow enemy movement speed and it applies some damage. Poison can be applied when interrupting targets and becomes significantly more powerful if interrupted again. Finally, herbs will enhance healing spells, giving a haste buff to the target. Nadia will also give Venthyr players 3 choices to suffer through because they probably would rather have the potency slot. Familiar Predicaments is a pure defensive, reducing the duration of some crowd control effects by 25%. Exacting Preparation adds bonus stats to the Well-Fed, Flask, and Weapon Enchant effects. Finally, Dauntless Duelist is a flat 3% damage increase to your first target in combat, which is like... come on, okay, I know that each of the Soulbinds have their own thing, but a flat damage buff sure feels a heck of a lot cooler than less magic damage taken, but maybe next week. But that's it for this week in Shadowlands, and I hope that these little reminders help you along. If so, please, oh please, like the video, share it with others, subscribe for more, and we will see you next time. Until then, stay safe, stay healthy, and stay breezy.